it's day 4 of Vlogmas and we're on our way into Manchester to the dentist to see dentist Sam, where I'm going to tell loads of tales on Lex not putting his liners in.
That's good.
No, he hasn't. He doesn't even have them in now. Look.
One day.
He went for a whole day on holidays without them in. And one day he left them on the coffee table. I'm telling Sam on him. He's going to have really crooked teeth and it's all his fault. So we're going to go to the dentist, which is right in Manchester City Centre in the House of Fraser. And then we're going to go and check out the Christmas markets. So I'll keep you updated. What was my weight today? My weight was 118, because yesterday it was 118.4. So it had actually gone up, but that was after training legs. So it's dropping back down again, because my legs were really sore yesterday and they're still a bit sore now. My butt hurts, doesn't it, Lex?
Apparently.
Yeah. So today's rest day. I've had my porridge with some Quest peanut butter protein powder in it, which is awesome. So if you haven't tried it yet, try it.
People all working in estate agents hating their lives.
So I'm wearing my Christmas jumper. So as you can see, yes, I'm very Christmassy.
Hello and welcome to Vlogmas.
Enough of her. Welcome to the Lex takeover.
No!
So, as you can see, we've incapacitated the Irish one.
Yeah.
Christmas spirit in full flow. She's getting teeth filed by Sam.
How's it touching your brain?
Just like kind of reverberates into my brain.
Right. Okay.
It's like nails on a chalkboard.
Which doesn't hurt her too much because it's a small Irish brain. I didn't mean that, Ireland. I love y'all, really.
Now it's Lex's turn for the dentist, but no one cares about Lex because he's really boring. So we're finished in the dentist. I have new liners in. We don't go back.
So sexy.
So we don't go back until March.
12
now.
Weeks.
Yeah. So it's the 11th of March, and now we're at the Christmas markets in Manchester. Ooh, and we're gonna go get coffee. Nice.
Oh, can I get a close up run across there?
Hello.
Hi. So we're coming to this Federal Cafe Bar, which I have wanted to go to for ages. This is like an Australian coffee company, so they do damn good food and drinks. Yuck. You sit down. Can we sit down?
What do you want? So you go sit down.
Coffee time. I got a cappuccino and Lex got a chai tea, which smells amazing.
It's like Christmas. Pick up.
Yum. So getting our coffee fix on and then
I want cake.
He won't let me have cake. It's a cod. Look how big it is. Ew. So it is crazy hair o'clock. No, it's 11:30 and I am tired. I'm just heading to bed. So I am Christmas jumper on top, pajamas on bottom. Oh yeah, I'm in my dressing room. Just going to take my makeup off because I've got my eyeliner still on and a million and one freckles. As you can see, I need to get my eyelashes done. I'm going to get them done on Tuesday. So today we went into Manchester. Max watched the dogs and people have been asking about Max. And Max is Lex and I's friend. We only actually recently kind of made friends with him since probably just before we moved into the new house. We met Max in the gym, in our old gym in Clitheroe, and he's just great. We get on really well with him, both me and Lex. He trains with Lex every day. Well, every day Lex trains. And the rest of the time he gets on really well with me. He looks after the dogs. He helps out with the Desire Fit Fashion orders. And he's just a great help and nice to have around the house. So people asking, who is Max, what is he doing? Yes, we have an adopted 21-year-old son, and he's called Max. And but no, Max is great, he's part of the family now, so sorry guys, there's no more room for adult children in the house. I don't know what that actually is, if anyone wants to join our family. But getting off on tangent now, I have my new liners in, they're kind of tight. So it's kind of nice to get the new liners in because they look cleaner, so my teeth look better. Because I keep on leaving them in when I'm drinking my coffee, which I really shouldn't do, which stains them, and then it looks like I have really yellow teeth, which I don't. So what did we do today though? We went to the dentist, got my liners, then we had a walk around the Christmas market, went and got amazing coffee in, what was it called? I don't even remember the name of the place. My memory is crap. It's on my Snapchat. Oh yeah, and I figured out why I wasn't getting views on my Snapchat. And if you guys were looking for me on Snapchat, it is Lainey Bopster. And it was because it had like defaulted to being private. So only my my own contacts could find me, but now everyone can. So we have changed that. So get onto Snapchat, you can follow my day, or all my days. And yeah, we just have random little conversations with the dogs and what we're doing throughout the day, making coffee, having fun in the kitchen. So me and Lex both on Snapchat. And so yeah, figured that out. And my camera died, so that's why I didn't vlog very much. We went for food in a place called the Cozy Club, just beside Selfridges in Manchester. And I had a chicken club sandwich, and it came with fries, and I had a mulled wine. And then for the rest of the day, I didn't, for breakfast all I had was my oats, and I didn't have a Quest bar all day. Had that coffee, and then we got these marshmallow things from the market. So it's like, I like a tea cake, but it's like, instead of having the biscuit at the bottom, it was like a wafer at the bottom, and then kind of fluff, like marshmallow fluff, and then covered in chocolate, but all of them were flavoured. So we got a few of them, so I ate two of them, and then I had a flapjack, a protein flapjack, which was yummy, and then that's all I've had. Yeah, so even though like I did have a big kind of, I suppose, fatty meal, for my lunch, that was it, because normally I'll have a Quest bar, which is like 8 grams of fat, and I didn't have that today, and I didn't have any dinner or anything, so I haven't done bad today really. Kind of feeling a bit peckish now, anyway. But still trying to watch my macros, but that is a way of balancing it out. I'm not saying starve yourself, but just kind of watch your food for the rest of the day. If you have had one big meal or something, just kind of like maybe have a high protein breakfast, or you know, an omelette for lunch or something like that. If you're going out for dinner, just go for lighter foods, so then you'll have kind of that buffer. Because when you go out for, like, we had chips, like that's gonna be fatty, and then okay, so we had chicken, but then there was like 3 slices of bread. So that'd be carbs and fats from the fries, then chicken, and there was bacon. Now we did ask for no mayo on the sandwich. We also asked for, instead of having streaky bacon on the sandwich, we got just the lean cuts of bacon, so no fat. So it wouldn't have been the worst meal. And then with alcohol, alcohol is a tricky one with macros, because alcohol is in fact its own macronutrient. And obviously we don't get a quota of them every day, even though I would love to. I'd love to be like, oh yes, I'm hitting my alcohol quota for the day. But no, we don't get an alcohol quota. So it is its own macronutrient. But when you're looking at alcohol, your body will actually use up alcohol before it actually uses up any of the rest of your macronutrients. So technically, if you eat after you've drank, your body isn't going to start, it's just going to store that food. Because it's going to be working away on the alcohol until the alcohol is out of your system. So you have to think about that the next day. Kind of put off taking in a lot of fats or carbs after you've had a lot of alcohol. Try and take in just like protein sources. But that's like, if you indulge on alcohol the occasional time, it's not going to like make a major difference to how you look. It's like if you're binging on it, you know, every week or, you know, a couple of times a week, then you kind of have to reassess how much you're drinking and how it affects your diet as well. Because obviously there's not just alcohol in alcohol, like alcohol isn't 100% alcohol, there's other things in it, and you know, things like ciders and beers, they're quite carb heavy, so you're getting carbs from them, so you just have to watch that as well. But over the Christmas period, enjoy a few drinks. Christmas Day is going to be an Infinity Macro day, and we're just going to enjoy our food. And like today, I knew that today was kind of me and Lex's day. It was our little Christmas, that we'd go and enjoy the Christmas market. And we bought some mistletoe, and we bought like a wreath for the door, which I'll show you tomorrow when it's hung up. We still haven't decorated the tree. We were meant to do it this evening, but then Lex didn't go to the gym until 9. So got a bit late and a bit tired, so we're going to do it in the morning, hopefully. But if we do, it'll be up in Vlogmas. What number are we on? It'll be Vlogmas 5 tomorrow. Wow, already. So we've got a week left until Christmas. I think we've gotten all our Christmas shopping. The guys from Muscle Food messaged me saying my food is going to arrive on the 23rd December, which is good. Looking forward to that. I'm putting in a big Asda order as well. I just want to get, we got loads of cheese at the Christmas market. So when my Asda order arrives and my Muscle Food, I'll obviously vlog that and I'll show you what I got food wise. Now, it's not going to be my usual macro friendly food, but I did go to Tesco yesterday and picked up a few kind of macro friendly treats for myself, so that I felt like, you know, because there's going to be people here who aren't concerned about eating macro friendly foods. Like my family, Lex's family, they're not going to be like overly concerned about watching their macros and I suppose watching what they're eating. But I want to still be able to enjoy some food without kind of being left out. So yesterday in Tesco, I bought, Weight Watchers have these like little bags of cookies. So I bought them so that if people are having like cookies and, you know, nice treats, at least I'll be able to have some of them. And like the macros are pretty good on them. It's like 3 grams of fat and 11 grams of carbs for a little bag of cookies. And then I also got some Fiber One little brownies as well. And just a few little treats so that I feel like I'm not being left out. As well as, so if you feel like over Christmas that, you know, everyone's going to be having like the treats, like still enjoy your few treats, still enjoy your celebrations and, you know, your chocolate. And like this year as well, I asked Lex last year, he got me a stocking and he had a pack full of chocolate. And I think he knows me better now. Like, we're going out with each other over 2 years now, and I suppose it's our third Christmas, but it's our second one together, and it's our first proper one, I feel, because we're hosting it in our house. And I just said to him, Lex, I don't want, you know me, I find it difficult to not eat chocolate when it's there, especially when it's mine. Like, if someone buys me chocolate, I'm like, mine. So last year he did buy me a lot of chocolate. Like, he bought me a massive big bar of Galaxy, he bought me like Reese's cups and like loads of the American chocolates that I like, you know, like the peanut butter M&Ms. And I sat and I ate them all and I was just like, please don't buy me that much. I was like, just buy me one like little Reese's like snowman or whatever, and like just buy me like minimal amount, because there's gonna be so much crap in the house anyway. So yeah, I think he's gonna stick to that, he understands. And I've bought him a whole tub of celebrations chocolates. So it's, and I've bought him like a yard of Jaffa cakes and a big chocolate coin. But I'm not going to get him much else, because there is a lot of chocolate in the house. So on that note, I'm very tired. I have a bit of a headache. I don't know whether it's, I didn't drink enough water today. So we were talking about it today. Water intake. Because Max says that he used to take in 6 litres of water a day. And there is, like, you should be taking in at least 2 litres a day. At least. And I take in 2 litres on the day that I train, when I go to the gym. Because I fill up my 2 litre bottle of water and I drink it. So I always take in at least 2 litres. But then I usually have, like, a big cup of water in the morning. And then I'll probably eat more, drink more water later on. At some point, I'll probably have a glass of water. And then, obviously, I'll be having water in my coffees. And I know that the Pepsi Max probably don't count, but I usually have a few cans of Pepsi Max. But, yeah, that's one thing. I think it should be everyone's New Year's resolution should be to drink enough water. Because staying hydrated, number one, when you're thirsty, sometimes it appears that you're hungry. Because I know that this evening, even, I was like, I'm so hungry. But I'd just eaten, like, an oat bar. And I was like, there's no way I can be hungry. So I drank a glass of water and I wasn't hungry anymore. So it was just thirst. So sometimes your hunger or your thirst can kind of display itself as hunger. Is that the right way of saying that? But Yeah. So drink your water, stay hydrated, and buy some healthy treats. Like buy some fruit and just some healthy alternatives. Maybe some low fat cheese and things like that, just so you don't feel like you're being left out of the fun over Christmas. And on that note, I'm gonna say goodnight and I shall see you guys tomorrow.